Ratnan Vannadal present here on behalf of PG and Research Department of Mathematics, Dwarakdas Govardhadas Vaishnav College. I welcome all the UG and PG students and research scholars for national webinar on application of Fuzzy models in the analysis of COVID-19. Now, Tamuthar Vaathu followed by college prayer.
நீராரும் கடலொடுத்த நில மடந்து கிழிலொழுகும் சீராரும் அதனமென திகழ் வளர்ந்த கண்டமீ எக்கணமும் அதிசிறந்த திராவிட நல் திருநாளும் தக்க சிறு பிறையுதலும் தரித்தனரும் திலகமுமே அத்திலக வாசனை போல் அனைத்துலகும் இன்பமுற எத்திசையும் புகழ் மணக்க இருந்த பெரும் தமிழனங்க தமிழனங்கே உன் சீரிழமை திறம் மிகந்து செயல் மறந்து வாழ்த்ததுமே வாழ்த்ததுமே வாழ்த்ததுமே
சத்யோரதம் சத்யபரம் त्रिसत्यं सत्यस्य योनिं निहितं च सत्ये सत्यस्य सत्यं ऋतसत्यनेत्रं सत्यात्मकं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्नः वाणी गुणानुकथने श्रवणो कथायां हस्तौ च कर्मसु मनस्तव पादयोर्नः स्मृत्यां शिरस्तव निवास जगत्प्रणामे दृष्टिस्सतां दर्शनेस्तु भवत्तनूनां नमो भगवते तस्मै कृष्णायाद्भुतकर्मणे रूपनामविभेदेन जगत्क्रीडति योयतः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः
इट्स गिव्स मी एन इमेंस प्लेजर टू इंट्रोड्यूस आवर रिसोर्स पर्सन Dr. A. Rajkumar, working as Associate Professor, Hindustan Institute of Technology and Science, Chennai. He received his undergraduate degree in Mathematics in 2001 and postgraduate degree in Mathematics in 2003, MPhil Mathematics in 2004 from Dayala College, Chennai, and PhD Mathematics in 2015 from Hindustan University. His area of specialization is Fuzzy decision making, artificial neural network, fuzzy clustering, fuzzy numbers. He has published 79 journals and 40 international and 39 Scopus index. SR delivered special lecture and invited talks in more seminars and international conferences and national conferences. We are extremely fortunate to have Dr. A. Rajkumar as our resource persons today with his introduction. With this introduction, I hand over the session to you, sir. Welcome, sir.
Thank you. So welcome to every one of you. Good afternoon to every one of you. Today I'm going to present application of fuzzy models in biomedical field, especially in COVID-19 pandemic situation. So I am Dr. Rajkumar from Associate Professor from Hindustan Institute of Technology and Science, Chennai. So today my topic is fuzzy modeling in COVID-19 pandemic situation. So first, before going to fuzzy, first of all, we have to know that what is fuzzy, why fuzzy is needed, what are the application of fuzzy. We have to know it. So why? Why we need fuzzy? What? What is fuzzy? How? How will set theory expand to fuzzy set theory? Fuzzy is a subset of mathematics. It comes under artificial intelligence or soft computing methods, and hard computing and soft computing. It has artificial neural network, genetic algorithm, and support vector machines. Just an example. Rom is tall. What is tall? I define 6 feet as tall. Somebody will define 6.2 feet as tall. Here, tall defines some number depending upon the person or the country. So the second one, what is the weather today? I say it is cold or hot. Somebody say it is hot. Somebody say it is less hot or average hot. The size of the chalk piece, it may be 2 centimeters or 2.1. So these are the basic examples of fuzzy. So next one is, what is crispness and what is vagueness? The value of the parameter or variable is exit. For example, crispness means if the weather is hot means we have to give 1. No means 0. Set theory always leads on 0 and 1 only. But a fuzzy set theory, it differentiates into different linguistic variables. Very, very hot. We can make it very hot. We can say very hot, medium hot, low hot, very low hot, very, very low hot. So we can use a linguistic variable to analyze the certain situation of weather. What is uncertainty and vagueness? I will come back soon, it is a vagueness. I will come back within a minute, it is uncertainty. I will come back from 1 p.m., it's a probability. Fuzzy set theory. There are some fundamentals. Before going to fuzzy set theory, first we have to know what is a classical set theory. We define a membership function, nu I of x equal to 1. If x belongs to A, if 0, if x belongs to A. You can say that the function maps the element of the universe x to the set is 1. In a set A, we see a element is present in A, a point of intersection is not present in element A. If belongs to A means we can define as 1. If it not belongs to A means we can define as 0. Fuzzy set theory. In fuzzy sets, each element is mapped to 0 to 1 by membership function nu A of xx belongs to 0 to 1. Where 0 and means real number between 0 and 1, including 0 and 1. You see the diagram here, represented the picture. A point is there in A, but there is a vagueness. There is a vague is given here. So the degree of membership is lying between 0 and 1 in A. So we can take the membership between 0 to 1. The characteristic of membership function. See, a new A belongs to 1. A and B belongs to set A, and C and D is not belongs to set A. See, represents 1 and B represents 1. C and D is not in the plot diagram, therefore it belongs to 0. But in the case of fuzzy set theory, you see here a point A and B is lies on A, and C is also holds on A, element A. Therefore, the characteristic function is represents. We can take this point as 0.5. I am taking A and B is 1, but the point C is I took a 0.5. But D is not in the in the element of A, therefore it's 0. Fuzzy set is a generalization of Cribbs set, was proposed by Jada. A fuzzy set A in X express a set of order 2 pairs. A equal X, new A of X. X belongs to capital X. Where A is a fuzzy set and X is an element, and new A of X a membership function, and capital X a universe of discourse. A fuzzy set is totally characterized by membership function. So you know who is the father of fuzzy? Father of fuzzy is Latif Jada. In terms of fuzzy set, let X equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 be the universal set and A be the subset. So new A of 0 represents 0, new A of 1 represents 0.5, new A of 2 represents 1, new A of 3 represents 0.5, and new A of 4 represents 0. A maximum value of the membership is called ith. Suppose the ith of some fuzzy set is less is 1. This fuzzy set is called normalized. This is a normalized fuzzy set. The graph shows this is a normalized fuzzy set. This attains the fuzzy set is maximum 1, therefore normalized fuzzy set. Fuzzy number. Fuzzy number also introduced by Jada in order to deal with impressive numerical quantities in a particular way. So it satisfies three conditions. It is membership function in piecewise continuous. Its membership function is convex. And u of x equal to 1. There are some fuzzy numbers. The first one is triangular fuzzy number. The triangular fuzzy number represents A1, A2, A3. And it is defined by membership function. New A of X equal to X greater than A1 means 0. And X minus A1 by A2 minus A1. X lies between A1 and A2. And X lies between A2 and A3 is A3 minus X divided by A3 minus A2. Greater than A3 means 0. Other types of fuzzy number is a trapezoidal fuzzy number. It's a trapezoidal fuzzy number. So its membership function is defined as if AX is greater than A1 means 0. If X lies between A1 and A2 means X minus A1 divided by A2 minus A1. If A2, X belongs to A2, A3 means its membership function is 1. the membership function is 1. If x lies between A3, A4 means A3, A4 minus x divided by A4 minus A3. Greater than A4 means 0. So these are the basic fuzzy numbers. There are other fuzzy numbers are there. Pentagonal fuzzy number, hexagonal fuzzy number, heptagonal fuzzy number, octagonal fuzzy number, nyanagonal fuzzy number, decagonal fuzzy number, heptagonal fuzzy number, dodecagonal fuzzy number, triskaidecagonal fuzzy number, pentadecagonal fuzzy number. There are n numbers are there in fuzzy. So we can, you can utilize the fuzzy numbers in various modeling our datas. So today I'm going to present a very easy modeling, because students, when I am giving the talk with the students, students are more interested to do the research articles. So I used to give a simple modeling, how to model the entire system. So today I'm going to give you a very easy model, how to model the coronavirus. Two methods I'm going to talk today. The first one is CTD matrix. Second one is triangular fuzzy number. So what is coronavirus? First, you have to know what is that. So for the last 2 years, we know about this virus and the specifications and the sickness and symptoms. So for the last 2 years, we are knowing about this. Coronavirus, a very large family of virus. It causes illness ranging from the common cold to more severe disease. The first known severe illness caused by coronavirus emerged with the 2003 severe acute respiratory syndrome epidemic in China. A second outbreak of severe illness began in 2012 in Saudi Arabia with the Middle East respiratory syndrome. And finally, a novel coronavirus is a new strain identified in 2019 called COVID-19 as cast a pandemic of respiratory illness. Coronavirus spread through droplets, virus particles released into the air when an infected person breathes, talks, laughs, signs, coughs, or sneezes. Larger droplets may fall to the ground in a few seconds. Particles accumulate. Many people are gathered, there is poor ventilation. Two important features of a spike protein is RPD, a kind of grappling hook that grips into the R cell, and evaluate site a molecular can opener that allows the virus to crack open and enter R cells. Next one is RBD. Spike proteins are developed effective target a molecular features on the outside of humans called ACE2, a respiratory including involved a regulating blood pressure. A person is infected with coronavirus, is contagious to other for up to 2 days before symptoms appear, and the remains contagious to other for 10 to 20 days, depending upon the immune system and severity of the illness. So today, the modeling is, we develop a model in Chennai city, especially analysis of COVID-19 in Chennai division of zonal 9, using combined effective time dependent matrix that is called CETD matrix. So we got the data from the government official from the zonal 9, Tenapet division. So we collected the data for almost 6 to 7 months. After collecting the data, we use this model to identify the peak age group is affected by COVID-19. COVID-19 is a viral pandemic that affects all of us in all over the world. The article discusses about the people who affected in COVID of Great Chennai Corporation during the second wave, where the novel coronavirus transformed into Delta variant. The maximum age gathering of individual affected by COVID-19 in the Greater Chennai Corporation was determined by using a CTD matrix. So I use the three processes: EATD matrix, refined time dependent matrix, CETD matrix. So fuzzy matrix, we have to know what is fuzzy matrix, and we have to know what is average time dependent matrix, and we have to know refined time dependent matrix, and finally we have to know CTD matrix. Fuzzy matrix. Fuzzy matrix is a matrix which has elements having values in the fuzzy interval. The unit lies between 0, 1 and the interval -1 to 1 are called fuzzy interval. The raw data gives a matrix representation. Entries corresponding to the intersection of rows and column values corresponding to the line network. Step one, I'm going to use some procedure to solve our model. The first step, raw data is transformed into raw dependent data matrix. Second step, the raw data converted into average time dependent matrix by dividing each entry of raw data matrix. This matrix represents data which is totally uniform. Third stage, the average or mean and the standard deviation of each column in the ATD matrix, determined in formula. ATD matrix then converted into refined time dependent data matrix. This matrix also at times termed as fuzzy matrix as the entries 1, 0, -1. The refined time dependent matrix, we are going to use it. One can combine this matrix by various parameters. So the combined effective time data matrix is obtained. The row sum is found for the CTD matrix and conclusions are derived based on row sums. All these are represented by graphs, and graphs play a vital role in exhibiting the data by simplest means that can be ever understood by everyone. So in a division 123 of Zonal 9, Tanampet of Great Chennai Corporation, Tamil Nadu, we interviewed 186 people. The causes of COVID-19. Affected people are elucidated using fuzzy matrix, which refers to RTD matrix, which is fuzzified by entries from the set 1, 0, -1. The number of people affected in COVID-19, which are taken as column of the first row matrix data, as well as the age group in the years. So first, symptoms. First, we have to know what are the symptoms they are affected. Fever, sore throat, cough, difficulty in breathing, loss of taste, loss of smell, body pain, diarrhea, headache, vomiting, rashes. So these are the 12 categories. We are going to identify the patients who are affected more. So these are the 12 criteria. First, the symptoms, the age group. Age from 0 to 10, we are taking the data from age 0 to 10 from above 80 years old. So first category, U1. What is U1? U1 is fever. U2 is sore throat. U3 is cough. U4 is difficult in breathing. U5 is loss of taste. U6 is loss of smell. So this is the data we have taken, U1 to U12. These are the data are affected by the patients. So U1 is affected in the age group 0 to 10, four children from 0 to 10. And 11 to 20 is affected by 12. Fever is affected 12 members from 11 to 20. And 61 to 70, 10. 51 to 60, 28. 51 to 50, 29 patients are affected by fever. Like that, U2, U3, U4, U5, U6. What is U6? U6 is loss of smell. So loss of smell is affected by, you see, the data 0 to 1, there is no children are affected by loss of smell. The people from young age 21 to 30, they are affected. 19 patients are affected by loss of smell. And 24 patients are affected by 31 to 40 age group. So this is a data we collected from the Corporation of Chennai, from Tanampet. From this data, I'm going to transform into fuzzy matrix, fuzzy refined data matrix. So what I'm going to do now? I'm going to divide this by number of data and 4 divided by number of data. So 10, total number of data is 10. So 4 divided by 10, 0.4. And 12 divided by 10, 30 divided by 10. Each data is divided by number of data. So we got the average time dependent ATD matrix. This is called ATD matrix. After getting the ATD matrix, we are going to find the average and standard deviation. Average and standard deviation. So average is sum of the data divided by number of data, and standard deviation summation x minus x bar by n minus 1. We have to use that formula. We have to find the standard deviation. After that, this data will be taken into a refined time dependent matrix. So we are taking the alpha cut as 0.25. What is alpha cut? Given a fuzzy set A, defined on X, and only number alpha belongs to 0, 1, then alpha cut are the crisp sets. A alpha is equal to X belongs to A. New A of X is greater than or equal to alpha. So we can take the alpha cut is lies between 0 to 1. We can choose any values between 0 to 1. It is defined as alpha cut. So we are going to change the ATD matrix into a refined time dependent matrix by taking the alpha cut as alpha equal to 0.25. So I will tell you one data how I am doing this. So we are using the formula to transform this data. Hello. The formula is if alpha ij is less than or equal to nu j minus alpha into sigma j, then eij equal to minus 1. If alpha ij belongs to nu j minus alpha multiplied with sigma j, comma nu j plus alpha star into sigma j, then we can give eij equal to 0. Else, if alpha ij belongs to nu j plus alpha multiplied with sigma j, then eij equal to 1. How we are getting this data? I will explain one. Go to the slide back. See, so this is a 0.2. This 0.2, we have to check with the formula how it transform into 1, 0 or minus 1. The formula already I told you. That formula we are going to use it. 0.2. So the formula, we can use the formula. 0.2 is less than or equal to nu j. Nu j is the average. Nu j is average. What is the average? This is the average. 1.3556 for nu 2. So average minus alpha cut. Alpha cut, we are assuming the data 0.25 into sigma standard deviation. What is the standard deviation? Standard deviation is 1.2156. So if you calculate this, we are getting the value 1.4. So 0.2 is less than or equal to 1.4. If 0.2 is less than or equal to 1.4 means we can give the data EAJ equal to minus 1. EAJ equal to minus 1. So we are applying EAJ equal to minus 1. Like that, each and every data will be transformed into a refined time dependent matrix by taking the alpha cut, by applying the formula. After getting this refined time dependent matrix, we have to add all the rows, minus 8, minus 10. We add these rows, we get these values. Then plot the graph in the graphical representation. Class interval will be taken as 0 to 10. Age group will be taken as 0 to 10. And we have to mark this data. The row sums -8, 0 to 10 is -8, 10 to 20 is -12, -10, -12, 12, 5, and 40 to 50 is 2, and 50 to 60 is 10, 60 to 70 is 5, and 70 to 80 is -12 and 5. Now this is a graph we are holding for the alpha hat. Alpha is equal to 0.25. So by using this various alpha cuts, we are taking the alpha cut alpha equal to 0.35. Again, we are plotting the point in the graph. Again, we are taking the alpha cut 0.45. We are plotting the point in the graph. Again, we are taking the plot alpha cut 0.55. We are plotting the point. Then alpha equal to 0.65. Alpha equal to 0.75. Alpha equal to 0.85. So we took most number of alpha cut to derive the graph. After getting all the plotting, of the graphs, we are making the CTD matrix. All the graphs will be plotted. You see, a maximum age group of COVID-19 affected causes using CTD matrix. So you see the group 31 to 50. You see maximum people are affected. So from the above CTD matrix graph, we can conclude that age group 21 to 30, by this number of affected cases, division 120 zonal is 36 during the period of April 2021 to June 2021. So 21 to 30 are the major people are affected in the Delta variant in the zonal number 9, 10 upper division. So this is a easiest model to know about which age group is affected by Delta variant in our zonal tenampet. This is one of the model. So how to prevent this? So droplets, common transformation routes are droplets, respiratory and contact spread. How to prevent? Avoid going to high epidemic areas and avoid closed airless public places. Wash your hands frequently. Try to avoid going to crowded places. Try to avoid contact with wild animals. How to improve your immunity? Proper exercise is required. Choose the right exercise for you. Strengthen your physical and cope with various disease risks. Develop good habits. Avoid bad habits. Eat more fresh fruits and vegetables. Pay attention to combination of work and rest. Avoid stress, avoid travels. So these are the common thing we have to follow to improve our immunity. From the above analysis, it is suggested that protect yourself and others around you by knowing the fact and taking the precautions. Always follow the guidelines implemented by the health authority of your region. Maintain social distance, wearing a triple layer mask while the social distance is not possible. The sustain of places must undertaken regularly. Wash your hands often when you are in the close places. Get vaccinated to avoid severe impact. This is the first model. So with the help of the model, we analyzed that what is the peak age group affected by Delta variant in the zonal 9, our area, Tenampet. So next one. There are a lot of symptoms are shown. So we have to find which is the most affected symptoms in the people in the region of Tenampet. So there are 12 symptoms we shown. So we have to find what is the major symptoms affected by the zonal 9. So we use a method called triangular fuzzy number, triangular fuzzy community maps. See, in this method, we use triangular fuzzy number, FCM, ranking method, and the properties of COVID-19. So first, we have to use the linguistic values of triangular fuzzy number. So the linguistic variables are, is denoted as very high, medium, very low. Very high can be taken as a linguistic values 0.7, 1, 1. This is a triangular fuzzy number. 0.5, 0.7, 1. Medium is taken as 0.2, 0.5, 0.8. And low will be taken as 0, 0.3, 0.5. And very low will be taken as 0.3. These are the linguistic values. The linguistic variables transform into linguistic values. The basic definition of triangular fuzzy quantitative map. The nodes of triangular FCM are called fuzzy nodes if nodes are fuzzy sets. Simple triangular FCMs are triangular FCM if edge weights or casualties are from the set -1, 0, 1. A triangular FCM is a directed graph with concepts like policies, events, casualties as edges. It represents casual relationship between concepts. Let C1, triangular C1, triangular C2, triangular CN be the nodes of triangular FCM, where triangular fuzzy number belongs to -1, 0, 1. A is called intensitized state vector and denotes the on-off position is a node at the instant. If triangular fuzzy number is 1, maximum weight. If triangular fuzzy number is 0, otherwise. A triangular fuzzy number is said to be cyclic if it has a feedback. When there is a feedback in triangular FCM, and the casual relation flows through a cycle in a revelatory way, a triangular FCM is called dynamic system. If the triangular FCM settles down with a state vector, repeating in the form A1 to AN, then this equilibrium is called limit cycle. Using the linguistic variable, we add the questionnaires and we have the expert opinion from the government officials, doctors from the region of Tenambet. So there are some few cases we have taken. These are the attributes. TRC1 is taken as loss of smell and taste. TRC2 is taken as cough. TRC3 is taken as vomiting. And C4 taken as body ache. And C5 taken as shortness of breath. And T6 is taken as headache. And T7 is taken as fever. T8 is taken as sore throat. And finally, C9 is taken as congestion. So these are the 9 attributes we taken from the zonal 9. We use this model to find out which is the most eye symptoms is affected in this particular region. There are 9 symptoms. From the 9 symptoms, what is the which symptom is affected more in the, especially in the region Tenambet? How to method the determine the hidden pattern? These are the procedure. Let us C1, C2 be the nodes of triangular FCM with a feedback. A triangular FCM via associate adjacent matrix. We have to take 1 to be an on state. It passes to the relation matrix and multiply by A by the triangular matrix M. Step 3. Let A1, A2, AN be a triangular vector. Suppose it gives a triangular weightage of the attributes. We call it as triangular weightage. After the corresponding node of the 3 experts' opinion, we call it as triangular M. Then threshold operation is denoted by symbol tilde. And it replaces AI by 1 if AI is the maximum weight of the triangular node. If otherwise, AI equal to 0. Suppose the triangular weight is nothing, addition of weightage of on attribute, and triangular M is weightage. Step 7. Adding the summation of 3 experts' opinion of each attributes, it is threshold again by tilde and replace AI by 1 if AI is the maximum weight of the triangular node, if AI equal to 1, otherwise 0. Continue the process until getting the dynamic system. The process is continued until getting the average of the representative data. So this is the data, triangular fuzzy matrix. So this is TRC1, TRC4, C, TRC1, TRC4, TRC1 and TRC4. What is TRC1? TRC1 is new loss of taste. TRC4 is body aged. So TRC1 and TRC4 in the particular region, it is donated by is donated by 0.5, 0.71. What is 0.5, 0.71? It is given as linguistic values. What is the value say? 54, slide 54. See, high 0.5, 0.71, it takes I. So, the loss of taste of smell and body pain in the particular region, it shows very high to the people. Like that, we are taken the data from the people affected in the particular region. The data is collected. After collection of data, we are using the dynamical system. By passing the dynamical system into the matrix and taking the data as a consideration, we are finding the limit cycle. For each, every attribute, first you have to take one as open node. First node is, what is the first attribute? You have taken open node. The remaining other nodes to be off node. And you have to multiply with the matrix. We have to take the average, which is the maximum weight. We have to take, given as the weightage is one. Again, we have to take that entire second row matrix and multiply it with zero, maximum weight 0.73, 0.9. And the maximum weight is 1.46. Multiply with the maximum weight. Again, which is the maximum value, give as one. Let us flow the cycle in the dynamical system to get a limit cycle. After getting the limit cycle, all the data will be, weightage of the attributes will be calculated. After weightage of attributes, add all the data and divide by total number of data, you will get a total average weight. So total weight and divided by total number of data, so we will get average total weight. From this, we can conclude that which is the most affected symptom in the people, especially in Tenapet region. From this, we concluded that, so from this 3.911. So 3.911 is shortness of breath. And 3.747 is loss of smell. And 3.43 is sore throat. 2.23 cough, fever, congestion, headache, finally body ache. So this is a ranking of the attributes that are affected in Tenapet region. The symptoms are affected in Tenapet region. This is the ranking the attributes. The first one is shortness of breath. So most of the people are affected in Tenapet region due to shortness of breath. And second one is loss of taste and smell. And third one is sore throat. Fourth one is cough. And fifth one is fever. So this is the order we found out by using fuzzy models. We found out using fuzzy models. There are some treatment protocol given by Indian Council of Medical Research. Mild disease. This already you know from all the papers they are given. The same thing only I'm putting here. Home isolation, systematic management, multivitamin tablets, stay in contact with the treating physician, monitoring temperature and oxygen saturation. And moderate disease means admit in ward, oxygen support is needed, anti-inflammatory is needed. And severe disease means you have to admit in ICU, respiratory support needed, anti-inflammatory therapy is required, anti-coagulation therapy is required. So these are the references we used. So these are basic models in FUSSY. You can utilize these models. We can utilize the statistics data from the current situation, from the regions, not only in COVID-19 epidemic. Any data you can collect, maybe it is a dengue culture, dengue fever, or it may be a typhoid, it may be a cardiovascular system disease, cancer. Any data you can take as a age group, affected by age groups. And you can use this models, a CTD matrix and triangular fuzzy matrix. And you can find out the affected the age group, which is a peak age is affected by the disease. And we can find out what is the ranking of the entire disease. That is the symptoms, ranking of the symptoms of the disease. These are the models you can apply. So you are a research scholar, mean you can take the data from the hospitals, from government officials. For example, if you want to do the data from diabetics, you can collect the data from the diabetic center and you can analyze by using these small models. There are a lot of models are available. This is a basic model in Fuzzy. You can easily model the data. Thank you very much. Instead of triangular fuzzy number, you can use a trapezoidal fuzzy number also. Instead of trapezoidal fuzzy number, you can use pentagonal fuzzy number. We can use hexagonal fuzzy number. When you are increasing the parameter, we can able to get the more accurate answers. When you increase the fuzzy number, we can get more accurate answers. We can reduce the vagueness of the entire dynamical system. Then fuzzy numbers can apply in engineering field also. You can apply the fuzzy numbers in engineering field. We can find out the fault tree analysis in the aircraft engine, in computer systems and lathe machines. These fuzzy numbers are used to find a fault rate of the entire system. So fuzzy number is widely used to find the failure rate of the entire system also. What is necessary to choose this model? The most of the people are affected in the month of March, April, May, especially April to June. So many people are affected. So many people are affected by COVID-19. But the government are not able to correctly, they are not able to tell us which age group is affected more. Sometimes they are giving the information above 50 to 50 above people are affected by Delta variant. And some of the days, some days they are telling 30 to 50. And some of the days we got the news 20 to 30. And there are a lot of confusions held at the time, in the month of March to June, because this is a new disease. So we are not able to analyze what is the current situation is going on, particularly especially in Chennai. So we thought we will have to do a work under this. So we decided we have to model the data and we have to find out which is the peak age is affected, especially one region. It is a we collected the data, especially in Thenambad region. We have 15 zonal in Chennai. We observed only a zonal 9, Thenambad region. This data is collected from only a few minimum patients and a minimum patients from higher sectors, government officials. We got the data from the government officials for minimum patients. This is a minimum data we used and we formulated the matter. We formulated the model. We have other regions also. The same model we can apply in other regions. You can find out the peak age, which age group is affected more, which age group is they leads to more death. You can find out by using this model with other zonal also. At the same time, the same triangular FCM, the matrix are also used to find the ranking of the entire system, ranking the attributes of the entire symptoms. So we can use that also. So, sir, you can utilize this model in other countries. It may be in the USA, you can use this same model in USA also. The people can utilize this model, they can find out in that particular USA's people, which age group is affected more and which age group is caused more death, we can find out. So So each and every places, we can apply this same model. We can find out the data for the particular country, particular region, and particular zonals also. So FUSSY is a wide range of models we have. A lot of models we are having. This is some basic models we introduced. And there are so many models are there, we can formulate the models in the biomedical field, in the engineering field, in optimization technique, and decision-making process, we can utilize this entire system. Then FUSSY is then transformed into nootropic FUSSY number. Now the nootropic FUSSY number is widely used to find the ranking of the entire system. The same model we can transform by taking the nootropic FUSSY number. What is the nootropic FUSSY number? We can analyze by three parts: truth, indeterminate, and falsity. So FUSSY number is introduced, it transforms into a nootropic FUSSY number. We can utilize that model for the same problem. We can find out the ranking of the symptoms. So thank you very much for giving me the great opportunity to spare our research field to the students, especially the research students from Vaishnav College. Thank you very much. If you have any ideas, you want to consult with me, anytime you can come and meet me in Hindustan University. So you can come and you can join PhD also. So we'll guide you in the right way.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Question and answer session, sir. Dear participants, any questions? Dear participants, any questions? Please post it in the chat box. Sir, I think no questions, sir.
Okay.
Thank you so much for your wonderful presentation, sir. And very, very useful for us.
Okay.
We express our sincere thanks to our management, Dorakdas Kovardadas Vaishnav College. We are thankful to our beloved secretary, Sri Ashok Kumar Mundraji, for his motivation. I would like to thank our respected principal, Dr. S. Santosh Babu, for his enthusiastic support. My sincere thanks to our head of the department, Professor R. Venkatramanan, for organizing this webinar series. A special thanks to the faculty of Postgraduate and Research Department of Mathematics. Thank you one and all. Our next webinar will be held on tomorrow at 2 p.m. Dear participant, feedback link posted in the chat box.